As you would expect from Patch My PC, software update compliance reporting is a major component of Advanced Insights. Here, we're looking at the software updates dashboard. One of the frustrations we hear from customers about the native capabilities of Configuration Manager is that there's no overarching view of the software updates landscape or any of the other disciplines Configuration Manager covers. If you know specifically what you need, there's a good chance you'll be able to find it. But if you just want an overview and then be able to drill through, then that's a little bit more challenging. So we're looking to provide those kinds of capabilities with this interface. These top-level dash stats provide visibility about the health of the environment. I can see that my software update point is currently synchronizing, for example. I can drill in to see additional details about that. I can see updates which are needed in the environment which are not yet deployed, so there's some work I need to do there. I can view compliance against this month and previous month's updates, and scroll back through these to view my compliance against those month's deployed updates. Should I want to see why my compliance against this month's updates is still so low, then I can drill into any of these statistics and see the specific details of those updates. This view is showing us not just the Microsoft catalogue, but also the Patch My PC catalogue and any others that you have available in your environment. As with everything in Advanced Insights, if you wish to see which machines require this Google Chrome update, for example, then you can always click on additional details. This view will show me the specific machines which are missing this update and the metadata associated with it. I can see details like the size of the update, how it's being deployed, which software update group it's a member of, and I can view deployment statistics for those update groups too. I can also drill in to see additional details. For example, to see the overall deployment status of all machines in the environment, I can see that data here, and then I can begin to drill in to discover why certain machines may be lacking compliance. This client is pending a restart, so I can drill into that further and see the specifics for that individual machine. I can view all of the updates which are currently required on that machine. If the appropriate thing for me to do at this point is to push a restart, or maybe I can invoke a further update deployment evaluation, I can trigger that from this interface too. We're trying to make sure that Advanced Insights is a tool that you can use not only for better presentation of your software updates data, but also give you the ability to interact. Page show me the scan states so I can see where machines are scanning successfully or maybe failing. I can see my least compliant computers and my least compliant updates. We have dedicated pages associated with all of these disciplines in the menu here. The software updates page gives me a verbose view of all updates which are synchronized into the catalog, whether they're deployed or not. I can use column filtering to only show updates which are deployed, for example, and I can also filter by products to only display Patch My PC updates. I can do that here. I can further filter to only show specified manufacturer updates in that view if I wish. That will then show me a summary view of that detail, and I can filter this by collection if I wanted to be able to just report on workstations and not include servers, etc. We know that most Config Manager environments use software update groups to deploy their updates each month, and so we provide a view of overall compliance against your software update groups. If I want to track my Windows 11 latest software update group compliance, I can do so here, as you'd expect. Again, I could drill in to see the specifics for the individual machines. I can see the details about all of the updates which are included in this software update group, and the individual compliance of those updates as well. Some organizations or roles are mostly interested in deployment statistics. Those are available in this view. Clicking on a deployment, I can see the specifics for all the machines which are compliant with this group of updates. I can see there's one machine which is not sent in its status, while everything else is looking healthy. The final area I want to look at in this quick view of our software updates functionality is our Microsoft Updates page. This is an example of where we're extending inventory data to bring in additional information to supplement the Config Manager dataset. We instruct the clients to scan the Microsoft Updates catalog and bring the results of that scan into this page. This allows us to surface products in use in the environment which we were maybe not aware of, and so will not have included them in our software update point scan. Here you can see that I have Windows 10 LTSB on a device which needs an update, and I've also got service packs that I should maybe deploy. I can see SQL Server 2016 updates and a variety of other products. I should either add these to the software update point manifest so that they will be included in my patching process, or maybe do a one-off deployment of these updates to bring things up to date. But either way, this page gives me great visibility into that missing piece. Similarly, we will also bring in details of manufacturers who have published drivers into the catalogue. This helps us to view where there may be an opportunity for us to improve stability and security by deploying these drivers out to devices that are requesting them. That brings us to the end of our brief tour of software updates in the Advanced Insights portal. Thank you for watching.